An expansion joint or a bellow is a flexible element which is intended to use in piping system to absorb expansion or contraction or deflection or bending in the piping system. Normally, expansion joints are used in piping system connected to equipment like pump, compressor, turbines, so that piping expansion and contraction, that means piping displacements, will be taken care by the bellow, and excessive load or piping displacement will not be transmitted to the connected equipment. That means connected equipment will remain safe and bellow will absorb the piping movement or displacement and protect the connected equipment like pump or compressor. Four basic movements can be applied on a bellow: axial movement, lateral movement, angular movement and torsional movement. Out of these four movements, torsional movement is not at all recommended because torsion will destroy the bellow, and bellow convolution joint with the bellow body may fail due to the torsion or twisting of the bellow. Now, number one movement is axial movement. Axial movement of the bellow is the change in dimensional length of the bellow. When bellow is compressed, then the movement is called negative movement, and when the bellow is expanded, then the movement is called positive expansion or positive movement. And unit of bellow spring rate, that means axial spring rate, is in newton per millimeter. Now you can see axial movement of the bellow, how bellow is contracting and expanding axially. Then second movement is lateral movement. Lateral movement means the relative displacement of one end of the bellow with respect to the other end perpendicular to direction of its longitudinal axis. And lateral movement unit, lateral spring rate unit, is in newton per millimeter. Now you can see lateral movement of the bellow. There is no axial movement, only lateral movement is there perpendicular to the bellow axis. Then third movement is angular movement, that means movement in degree. It is the rotational displacement of the longitudinal axis of the bellow. Now you can see angular movement of the bellow, how the bellow is taking angular movement. Then fourth movement is torsional movement, that means rotation or twisting of the bellow about its center axis. This type of torsion actually not suitable for the bellow, because in case of torsion or twisting, bellow joint with the bellow body will fail. Convolution joint to bellow body will fail because convolutions are very thin, and due to the twisting or rotation of the bellow, bellow will lose its pressure retaining capability. Also, bellow will lose its other movement capability, like axial and lateral movement capability of the bellow will be reduced due to torsion. So torsional movement is not at all recommended for any bellow. Now you can see a bellow. This is a single bellow. These are the convolutions, and this is the body. This size is 5 piece, this side is 5 piece. This is bartwelled end bellow, and now you can see the movements. Actually, four movements bellow can take. One is axial movement, axial compression or expansion. This is axial compression. You see, this is compressed, and this is axial expansion, like this. So axial compression is negative and axial expansion is positive. Bellow spring rate in axial direction means axial spring rate of bellow is in newton per millimeter or kg per millimeter. Next movement is lateral movement. Lateral movement is movement of the bellow perpendicular to the bellow axis. That means along this movement is called lateral movement. This is the lateral movement. And bellow spring rate and lateral spring rate of bellow is in newton per millimeter or in kg per millimeter. Now third movement is angular movement. This is the angular movement of the bellow in degree. Now fourth movement is
Torsion. Torsion means twisting of the bellow with respect to other end. That means like this. Like this. This is called twisting. Like this. Twisting of the bellow. This twisting actually is not allowed for the bellow and dangerous for the bellow. For this twisting, this convolution will crack from the body joint.
You can see construction of a bellow. Bellow is constructed from thin SS sheet from 0.2 mm thick to 1 mm thick depending on application. And this convolution may be of single ply, may be of double ply, triple ply, depending on pressure and the application.
Now you can see the construction of a bellow. These are the bellow convolutions. These bellow convolutions are made from thin SS sheet from 0.2 mm thick to 1 mm thick depending on service. And these convolutions are welded here with the pipe piece, end pipe piece. It is welded here. These bellow convolutions act as a spring. When compressed, the convolutions are compressed like this, and when expanded, it expands like this. So these bellow convolutions are like a spring. It can be compressed, can be expanded, or it can take lateral movement like this.
Now axial pressure thrust of the bellow. Actually, bellow convolutions are flexible like a spring, and when an unrestrained expansion joint or bellow is placed into a piping system, then it will act like a cutting off pipe, cutting off pressurized pipe at center, so that due to pressure, pressure thrust will be generated that is equals to internal pressure into cross-sectional area, and that much of pressure thrust will be generated in both direction of an untied or unrestrained bellow. This axial pressure thrust is equals to pressure into cross-sectional area of the pipe, actually cross-sectional area of the mean diameter of the bellow convolutions. Now coming to various type of expansion joints or bellows. First type is single untied bellow. This type of bellow is having one set of single convolution and untied means there is no tie rod. That means this type of bellow can only be used in very low pressure piping system so that axial pressure thrust will be very less and that much of less pressure thrust can be transmitted to the equipment. So this type of single untied bellow can be used in very low pressure application like discharge of fan, discharge of blower like that where pressure is very low and so that axial pressure thrust is very less. Then universal untied bellow means this is also untied bellow but two sets of convolutions are there. That means bellow length will be more. This type of bellow also can be used in low pressure piping system but this type of bellow can take more axial compression or expansion and more lateral deflection also because two sets of convolutions are there. But use of this bellow is limited to very low pressure piping system. Then tied lateral single bellow means this is single convolution set of bellow but tied, not untied. It is with the tie rod. That means this bellow can be used in a piping system where pressure is high and there will be no axial thrust because axial pressure thrust will be taken care by the tie rods. But due to single convolution, this type of bellow will take very less amount of lateral movements.
This bellow only to take lateral load. Laterally it will be like this. Laterally it can move like this. If you lose this nut, then inside pressure is say 10 bar or 7 bar. 7 bar into this cross-section area, that axial force will act on this bellow and this will try to expand like this. That's why this nut should be kept tight. That's why two nuts have been given. One is nut, another is lock nut. You tight it. And upper one also you tight it like this. You tight, 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 tight. only you keep 1 millimeter gap. 1 millimeter gap here, then you tight this lock nut. After keeping 1 millimeter gap, you tight this lock nut, and for below one also, here you keep 1 millimeter gap, here you keep 1 millimeter gap. Here also you keep 1 millimeter, here also keep 1 millimeter. That means you are providing axially only 1 millimeter and laterally 15-20 millimeter. So 1 millimeter gap will be there, then you tight this lock nut. Like this you tight. If you keep it here, then it will try to expand like this, and that much of nozzle will, the load will go transfer here, because it will try to expand due to axial load. If this diameter is huge, then that axial load will be huge. It will be 10 ton, 20 ton. So this gap will be like this, only 1 millimeter. It can expand 1 or 2 millimeter, not beyond that.
Then tied lateral universal bellow means this is universal bellow. That means two sets of bellow convolutions are there, but bellow is tied. That means axial pressure thrust will be taken care by the tie rods, but due to two sets of convolutions, bellow can take more amount of lateral deflection or lateral movement.
Now you can see one universal bellow, tied universal bellow. This is tied universal bellow, means two set of convolution, one set of convolution this side, another set of convolution this side. So if you imagine no tie rod is there, then it is an universal bellow. Since tie rod is there, this side one tie rod and this side another tie rod, it is called tied universal bellow. This bellow is 8 inch size, BW end, butt weld end, and you can see two tie rods, tie rod nuts are there. Now what can happen if we remove these two tie rods? This bellow size is 8 inch, that means 20 centimeter is diameter. Cross sectional area of the bellow is 400 centimeter square, and if inside pressure is 20 bar, then 20 into 400, that means about 8 ton. 8 ton axial thrust will act on this side and on this side. So for to resist that 8 ton axial pressure thrust, these two tie rods have been provided, so that these two tie rods will take care of that axial pressure thrust. If we lose these two tie rods nuts, then this 8 ton will come this side and 8 ton load will go that side. That means load will be transferred to the piping system or load will be transferred to the connected equipment. Now these tie rods should be tack welded here and tack welded here also, so that mistakenly nobody can lose the tie rod nuts. If by mistake anybody lose these tie rod nuts, then huge pressure thrust, that much of pressure thrust will go to the piping system. Also during running condition, due to vibration, this nut and lock nut may get loosened. So better to tack weld here and here, so that this will be always remain as tight condition. Nobody can lose it. If we lose it, then this much of axial pressure thrust will go to that side and this side also.
Then hinged bellow. Hinged bellow means two sets of hinge joints are provided on the bellow. One set of hinge on one side and other set of hinge on other side. And due to the hinge joint, bellow will be able to take angular movement as well as lateral movement. And due to the hinge joint, bellow will not be able to expand axially. That means no pressure thrust will be transmitted to the piping system. But the hinge joint bellow can take angular or lateral movement only in one plane.
Now from this video you can see how a hinged bellow takes angular movement in one plane. Now from this video you can see how a hinged bellow takes angular movement in one plane only.
Then gimbal bellow. Gimbal bellow is a modified design of hinged bellow. Instead of two sets of hinges, in gimbal bellow four sets of hinges are provided, so that gimbal bellow can take angular movement and lateral movement in any plane due to four sets of hinges. And the gimbal bellow will also not expand axially due to internal pressure. That means no pressure thrust will be transmitted to the connected piping or connected equipment. Now you can see movement of a gimbal bellow. There are four hinge joints and gimbal bellow can take angular movement with respect to any hinge joint. That means it can take angular movement in any plane.
Now I am just in front of a big special bellow. It is called hinged gimbal bellow, 32 inch hinged gimbal bellow, special bellow. You can see one hinge is this side, right side one hinge and left side another hinge. It is called a hinged gimbal bellow. These hinges allows the bellow to take lateral deflection but prevents the bellow to expand axially. If the bellow expands axially, then huge axial pressure thrust will go to the piping system. Really big hinged gimbal bellow. One set of convolution this side, another set of convolution that side, and this is actually carbon steel bellow, but these convolutions are of SS. One hinge and this is another hinge, big hinged gimbal bellow.
Then elbow type pressure balanced bellow. This type of bellow is used as an elbow and two sets of convolutions are there. One set of convolution is on piping side and another set of convolution is on other side. When the piping side bellow is compressed, then other side bellow gets expanded and balances the pressure. That means in this type of bellow also, no pressure thrust will be going to the piping system. Then another type of bellow is braided hose or braided bellow. This type of bellow will have convolutions inside and SS wire braiding is outside, and SS wire braiding protects the bellow to expand axially. This type of braided hose or braided bellow can be used as a lateral bellow. We will get lateral movement benefit from the bellow, but due to the wire braiding, this type of bellow will not expand axially due to internal pressure. This type of bellow is used up to 6 inch or 8 inch size. This is a braided hose or braided bellow. Normally braided bellows are used up to 6 inch or 8 inch size, not beyond that. And you can see this is the stainless steel wire braiding outside and bellow is here inside. You can see the bellow convolution here. You can see the bellow convolution here. Bellow convolution is inside and this is the wire braiding to protect expansion of the bellow due to internal pressure. You can see this bellow cannot be expanded, but this bellow can take this type of lateral or angular movement, but this bellow cannot be expanded like this. So due to internal pressure, this bellow will not expand and only it will take lateral movement or angular movement like this. So we will get benefit of lateral or angular movement from this braided hose or braided bellow. And this braided braiding part protects the bellow to expand against the pressure. So in case of braided hose or braided bellow, no pressure thrust will be transmitted to the connected equipment.
I am in front of a pump. See, this is braided hose, or we can call it braided bellow. This is bar weld and braided bellow. It will give only lateral flexibility. Lateral flexibility of the pump installation, but it cannot be extended. This actual bellow convolution is inside, and this braided wire is providing strength so that it cannot expand axially due to internal pressure. Thank you.
you see a bellow drawing, these are the bellow convolutions of thin SS sheet, and this bellow convolution is welded with the bellow body at this point. Naturally, this point is very weak because this bellow convolution is of very thin sheet. That's why this type of bellow cannot take any twisting or torsion because this joint is very weak. Due to torsion or due to twisting, this joint may fail. This is the internal sleeve which protects bellow convolution inside from fluid flow path. So this internal sleeve should be along the flow direction. That's why bellow must be mounted as per flow direction indicated in the bellow. If the bellow is mounted in reverse direction, then flow will be from this direction and flow will directly hit into the inner sleeve. And another important point, in case of large compressors or turbines, sometimes it happens that machine may have fluctuating flow or pressure pulsation. If fluctuating flow or pressure pulsation is there, then naturally there will be backflow. In that case, flow will be like this, but due to fluctuating flow, there will be backflow, and that backflow will hit the inner sleeve, and due to that several hitting, this inner sleeve may get failed and bellow may fail. Now you can see internal sleeve. This is the internal sleeve. This internal sleeve has been provided to protect the convolution. When any fluid will pass through the bellow in huge velocity, then it will hit the convolution. That's why this internal sleeve has been provided in the bellow, so that fluid will not hit the bellow convolution inside. Now, one reason of bellow failure is if the equipment is having fluctuating flow, say any pump or compressor is having pressure fluctuation, that means backflow is there, that fluid will flow back to this annular space and hit the annular space. That means it will hit the bellow internal sleeve, and after several hits, then bellow may fail.